I'm going to show you how to remake a pair of pants. Well, I'm really going to try, but it's raining out here today and our lighting's really bad in the house. But anyway, I bought some of these really nice soft cotton, 100% cotton cords. And I bought them over a year ago and I really haven't been wearing them because I don't really like wearing belts and cinching in my clothes because they were about 2 inches too big in the waist. So these pair that I'm wearing here now, they've been taken in and you can't even notice where they were taken in. So I'm going to show you what I do to take in a pair of pants and they fit really, really nice now that I got the waist taken in. So it's really simple. You don't need a sewing machine. Took me a little while to figure out how to do it. So I'm just going to bring the camera over into some better light here. And hopefully I can show you. All right, so I have another exact same pair of pants in a navy color. And here's the waist on these pants and it's much, much too big. And so I needed to take it in about 2 inches. So I'm gonna do up the pants and do up the zipper. And of course I'm gonna take, instead, before I did try taking it in down the bum seam, but that only bunches it up, so that's no good. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take in an inch on each side of the pants, and you can do this by hand. If you have a sewing machine, it'll probably go quicker. And I'm not gonna show you the whole thing here because it may take too long. But essentially, what I don't even pin it. You can pin it if you want to be tidier about it, but I'll show you again. Can't even find where I took it in. Okay, here's where I took in the pants, right down along to the bottom of the pocket here and up along this seam. And that's essentially all I did, was I cinched it in from the pocket. And when I'm stood up, it doesn't even look bunchy. You can see a little tiny pleat going down into the pocket there and it's hardly noticeable. So alright, what I did was I just found the seam that runs along the pocket. I hope you can see this. And I was really lucky because my belt loop is actually 1 inch, which is what I need on each side, from that seam. And so I could just follow along with the belt loop. And all I'm going to do, because I'm going to do these ones too, is take this belt loop and pinch it down to this seam right here that runs along the outer edge of your pocket. So you're going to pinch it from the bum side, let's say, and bring it in like this. And then you have your inch here that's taken in, and now you want to taper the pants as they go along. And it's really easy with a corduroy because you can sort of follow along the seam. So all I did was pinch it along down the pocket until, I'm wondering if you can see this, until the whole thing has a little pleat all the way down the seam here. Now you can pin it at this stage if you want, but you don't have to. I don't. I just pull it back into shape as I go because I hand sew. So then all I'm going to do is take my needle and thread, pinch that back into place, and sort of hide it as close to or under the belt loop as you possibly can. So what you'll have is an overlap right here next to your belt loop. And it's the same thickness as your belt loop, so you don't even notice it. And I'll just stitch along the top too, to stitch that right back into place. But I start off with, I come underneath the fold that I just made. And if you got an end of thread that's sticking out like that, just poke that down and that'll get sewn right into it. That's not a problem. And then just start stitching by pulling up a little piece of the fiber here and grabbing a little piece of the fiber there. So, and you're just stitching. I don't know names of stitches or anything like that. I just do whatever. These hide in really well. So essentially that's all you're doing, is grabbing it along like this and pulling down. And you don't see this stitch here. So you pick up two little pieces of fabric and pull down. And you continue right on down to the bottom of your pocket like this. And remember, as you go down to towards the pocket, you want to taper this in. And then when you're all finished the seam down to the bottom of the pocket, all you have to do is come back up and stitch this fold over together really tight. And you won't feel it. And you do the same thing with the other side. So I'll show you this little fold over, what it looks like when it's all stitched together. This is where I sewed it back together here, and there's the seam. So you barely notice it. It's not even as thick as this little belt loop there. And yeah, so it's all tidy. And the benefit with doing it this way is another no-cut method, just the same way as I hem the bottom of my pants. When I hem up the bottom of my pants, I fold them in an accordion manner and then hem them up. These need to be ironed out now because I did that as well. And that way, if you ever need to let it out, or if I happen to gain weight and I need to let these pants out up here, you can let it out and you don't have to waste your good clothes, especially when you've got them all comfy and you love them. So that's a way that I came up with to take in a pair of pants in the waist, and it's pretty easy and anybody can do it, and you don't even need a sewing machine. So anyway, I'm going to continue on and finish off these pants. And if you have any questions, I know the lighting's not good and everything here, but it's pretty simple. But you can post down below and I'll try to answer any of your questions. All right, so that's it for this Make It Monday. Taking a pair of pants, pretty easy, and there's no need to cut them and no sewing machine necessary. And you can always let them out again. So this is a great alteration for kids. Like if you have a little bit bigger kids' clothes and you're waiting for them to grow into it, you can actually alter it down. And same with the legs, hem them up, and it's really easy to let out in the future if when they grow or anything like that.